Oracle Association regular meeting, Monday, September 21st, 4:30, will come to order. Lynette, call the roll, please.
Jim Gamble.
Here.
Chuck Grace. Andrea Dixon.
Here.
Bonnie Porter.
Here.
Laura Pat.
Here.
Richard Mullins. Jerry Daniel.
Here.
Here.
Richard here.
Look.
It's been many all that had to turn.
Look over your minutes, please, of the last meeting on August 17th. Are there any corrections or additions?
I'll second.
Do I have a motion to approve?
Make that motion.
Motion made and seconded.
I'll second.
All in favor, say aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Look over your financial reports. See, we got some painting done, didn't we, Russell?
Yes, we did. The church has finally got this, been painted.
Good, good, good. Does the core know?
Yes, I took them down and looked at them. They're 100% satisfied.
Well, if they're happy, we're happy then. Anything else on in there? Anyone have any questions on? Now, do I have a motion to approve the financial report and payment of August bills?
Motion to approve.
Motion made by Andrea, second.
I'll second.
Second by Richard. All in favor, say aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Russell, it's your night. Okay.
Russell just said that.
He ran.
Okay, I heard somebody say Russell.
That's right. We thought you didn't want to tell, so you just left.
Actually, I'm elected to be chairman tonight, so you're the chairman and I'm the chairman.
Okay, the chairman. Well, you've got the best job.
Well, September, despite how we did in August, September, there's probably going to be, if it keeps on going like it has been, it's going to be a record-breaking month for us. Basically, we've had quite a few tourists come in. We've had weddings every weekend of this month, and we had a real good turnout. I think it was up. We had like 540 students come in during that, and our gift shop sales for those 2 days was better than $1,400.
Right.
So that was real good.
So we split with the people. How much was our split?
No, we don't. It's not a split now.
I thought we got $3 and they got $2.
That's the way it is. But that's except on the grandparents, and they give up $1 for the grandparents' ticket. We get $3 and they get $1 on grandparents.
Mm-hmm.
So that's what that
was. So,
but it went real well.
How much did we take in?
I think altogether with, I've not did a breakdown of everything yet, I haven't had time,
mm-hmm.
But on the 2 days was like $4,700, I believe, for the 2 days. That's gift shop sales, and we have one school that has a payment. We have to send them a PO on that.
Mm-hmm.
But it really went well.
Thanks.
Good.
And we have, actually have two more schools scheduled for this month, too. We have one out of Pikeville and one out of Prestonburg. With the Prestonburg school has 150 children coming in, and the Pikeville school has 100. So we still have 250 coming in this month.
Did the lady get a hold of you today from Perry County? I told her to go ahead and call you all and get scheduled. She wants to bring students from Perry County this month as well.
This month,
mm-hmm.
But she never got over.
She probably will. That was that
we had
day.
One lady call today and schedule one for October. So.
Good. Well, that's what it's there for.
Yeah. I think that educational component could really help.
So
for that commune up there.
Mm-hmm. And our committee that's working on that's already got two volunteers from the two school systems. We're still working on the others right now.
And what was that for?
To work on educational programs right there for the home place and the museum as well. But to get more people there. Anything else?
Well, we did get your pumpkins on, I did.
Okay.
They're all waiting on you. I have no idea now. Nobody told me when anybody was coming to get them. Is that going to be this week or? Because we had to unload all those at the amphitheater.
Mm-hmm.
What I did, I put them on old hay. I took some old hay down and put them on.
Okay.
So they wouldn't be in contact with the concrete. So we got them all stacked up there. I couldn't take them to the barn because if I was actually taking them over to the barn, then you'd have deer and everything else that would have been in them and back to work some of them.
Yeah. Okay.
But they're out of the sunlight?
Yeah.
Off the ground.
Off the ground.
Okay.
I'm not sure what day they've got scheduled.
We're still waiting to hear.
You're back from
the
to be picked up. Okay. Anything else on that?
The horse is doing real good and he should be in real good shape for the Dawkins Trail ride. Bid's doing real well.
When's that?
That's going to be October the 24th, I believe. So he should be in real good shape. I've got a farrier coming in. That's actually going to put shoes on him around the 5th of October. So once we do that, then I'm going to start him just from, you know, around Mountain Home Place, start driving him every day to get him in shape before that trail ride. Because you're talking about 18 miles. So it takes, you know, he's going to be in pretty good shape to do this.
Yeah. Yes, I don't think anybody in here can do it.
Stephen.
Anything else on the home place? Any questions y'all have for Russell or anything? If not, is there a motion to adjourn the Historical Association?
Make that motion to adjourn.
Motion made. Second.
I'll second.
Second. All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Opposed. Okay. Paintsville Tourism Commission regular scheduled meeting Monday, September 21, 4:40. Roll call, Lynette, please.
Jim Gamble.
Here.
Chet Crace. Andrea Dixon.
Here.
Bonnie Porter.
Here.
Laura Pack.
Here.
Richard Mullins.
Here.
Jerry Daniel.
Here.
Go over your minutes from the regular meeting and the special meeting there.
I'm gonna make a motion to approve.
Motion's made to approve. Is there a second?
I'll second.
And second. Any discussion? Any corrections or additions? If not, all in favor say aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Okay, please go over your financial reports. You have one on there for the tourism and the museum, both. Motion made to approve. Is there a second to that, please?
I'll second.
Discussion? All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Ayes have it. Lynette, while we're on that, are the receipts still about the same? Are they
I think August we had a pretty good month. I believe it was 70. A little over 74,000 for the month of August, so it was good.
Okay. She's got the museum on down here on that. We'll go ahead, if you looked at that, go ahead and approve it too while we're at it. Any questions on it, on that one? I don't see anything out of the ordinary. Have a motion to approve that, please.
I'll make a motion to approve.
Motion by Laura. Second.
Second.
Second by Andrea. All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Opposed? We just take it in order. We've got it here. It's not old business, but it's in my stack that way. Plainsville Tourism Amendment to Bylaws. You all have that. Commission shall meet monthly or as needed, with regular meetings being held on the third Monday of each month immediately following the Plainsville Lake Historical Association meeting at 4:30 or such time to be designated by the chairman of the commission or upon joint call of any three commission members. This is to certify the foregoing copy as a true copy of the Plainsville Tourism Bylaws adopted by the Tourism Commission on September 21st, 2015. The only change on that is changing it from 4 to 4:30. Are there any questions? Do I have a motion to approve the bylaw change?
Motion.
Motion's made and second. Okay, old business, the Pumpkin House. Can we have an update on that, please?
Well, Wade is going to go over and look about building the riser for it. As you can tell, we've got them delivered. Laura and I are going to go to the schools and then we
have the flyer done. It's ready to distribute. We also have instructions for the teachers. We've put together a ribbon and age group division for the prizes. We just need the risers built, and of course we need to get the Stafford House sign up before we do that, and I'm having a heck of a time with the vinyl post. We all decided on the black vinyl post.
Mm-hmm.
We can't get those black vinyl wraps. Nobody will make them, so we're going to have to buy the wraps and install them ourselves. They won't make the solid black post for whatever reason, and I've probably contacted 12 to 15 companies.
1-800-SIGN.
I tried them.
Try those.
They'll do the wraps for us.
Uh-huh.
They won't do the solid drop over post cover.
Okay.
But they'll sell us wrapped material,
mm-hmm.
and then we have to buy the finials that top them separately, the topper caps. But so we have pumpkins, we have instructions, we have flyers, we have everything but risers and lights, and the house ready to go. We need to get the house ready to go in a short time. We've got some volunteers to help distribute the flyers and whatever pumpkins can't be picked up by the teachers. Or
mm-hmm.
So we have some volunteers for that.
Good, 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 good.
We're excited.
It's going to be fun.
Yeah.
I see more and
also
more of those advertised, not just here, but around different locations. Okay, Stafford House. We are progressing, aren't we, Joe?
We're progressing.
Got some applications here.
Yeah, we've just got to fill out the actual loan applications. We've got the correct deed description. It's about 3/4 acre surrounding the house. It goes back to the drive with egress and ingress into that. And it was at one time surveyed, so there's markers over there someplace.
Yeah.
Just digging
sure.
them out. Like
but they're still
else.
Stacked. They're still there.
Yeah.
Because remember, Yeah, shows.
Should we want to do some, and I had this question I meant to ask you previously, but should we want to do something to incorporate a set of steps up to the cemetery or something? Will we have access to it?
We don't, but I don't think there's going to be any issue there.
Okay.
It's been so cooperative. The same
yeah.
thing with access to the river or the creek, if you want to do that.
Good deal.
I did.
We talked about that.
Yeah, I think both those ideas are really viable
yeah.
for
getting
folks in.
He seemed agreeable
yeah.
about anything. He just wanted to see it improved and progress. New business on funding requests. Now, none of these we have to decide on today, do we? These are all to go to the committee,
yes.
right?
Uh-huh.
They're just now, but they weren't submitted previously. The fishing swap meet, which we have done in the past, and what was
that request is for $1,500.
Is that the same one we've done for the last 3 or 4 years?
The same one, uh-huh.
That's a.
And the event will be held on February the 20th of next year.
You refresh our memory, how many visitors they expect and rooms and such and so forth?
That one they probably had between 500 and 1,000, I
yeah.
know.
They had a pretty good one.
They have a bunch in there.
Yeah.
I mean it's
yeah.
two
it's
years ago.
I get walk around business from
there.
<around.
Yeah.
laughs>
I'm all for it.
I've been a couple of times, they get a good crowd in there.
Yeah.
Yeah, they
from a lot of areas.
2 or 3 years ago I went through there. Just walking from the parking lot because they had to park on the other end of the middle school and counted 7 states and 50 some different counties, just counting cars as I went along that were there. That was 2 years ago, I don't know, last year. They didn't have the fish dinner, so I didn't go. I'm not a fisherman.
Probably wouldn't take much for Dwight Burchard to fry something up.
Yeah, Hornchip, he's there every year.
Yep.
Selling his lures. I have to call him anytime I get an auction that has old fishing equipment in it. He wants to know.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, holiday happenings.
We have a request for that. The request is for 2,000, and the event will be held at the Ramada on November the 13th through the 14th. That's the request for that.
We all received this. It already says we're sponsoring it.
Really?
Yeah.
That was mailed today. Sent out with the invitations that arrived today. Everyone got their invitation to it. It says that we are sponsoring.
We just got that
one. Monday last week, Wednesday, Thursday.
Yeah,
something like that.
Yeah. Okay. Holiday Classic Wrestling Tournament. Now this is one that came to us last year, but it was right before it happened. We didn't have the well, just one time. We didn't have the funds or in the set aside for that or anything.
That is a very nice event that brings in a considerable amount of people.
Well, it was, I remember looking over that application, it was like 40 rooms
mm-hmm.
For 2 nights, so 80 room nights, and they had over 500 in attendance.
Yeah.
Easily.
Easily. And that
I know when
double.
I worked at Toyota, they talked about this wrestling tournament.
Uh-huh.
Mm-hmm. You know, Harrison County's a big wrestling county, and so is Woodford County, and they
yeah.
always talk about coming down to them.
Yeah, Woodford County and Harrison both have won a state in the last
yeah.
few years.
And well, not just inside the Commonwealth. I have friends who live over in Virginia, and they bring wrestling enthusiasts from Virginia, from the other side
yeah.
of Virginia,
yeah.
clear over here for this
yeah.
tournament. And they book rooms every year and have ever since they've had it.
Yeah.
So,
West Virginia,
yep.
Virginia and Ohio, all three.
It's a great event.
Okay. And I already...
Much of that.
I'm taking my pages in order
there.
I don't
think
there.
They asked for much.
Miles.
I think it's 29.
I get,
that's all.
I'll get
yeah,
the net all mixed
they're
up.
They're booking. Send me with this.
Yeah.
I like
yeah.
it. It's a little bit, yeah, a little bit different.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
When is the wrestling
yes.
tournament?
No, that's what I was trying to say.
It's all, it's during
Christmas.
Christmas.
Christmas
yeah.
break.
Right.
It's during Christmas break. Okay, Jimmy, Otto, you all have something. You're not on the agenda, but you don't need to be to speak.
Four or five weeks ago, I presented to the commission here about funding for the Kentucky Apple Festival. My request was for $20,000, $15,000 to support the needs of the Apple Festival and its activities, $5,000 to support the great work that the city employees do. For whatever reason, that request has been altered and morphed into some sort of funding that represented $5,000 for the Kentucky Apple Festival, $5,000 for advertisement, and $10,000 for the city of Paintsville's cleanup. So I'm back to inquire at how we got to that point, deviating from my actual request to the commission.
Well, that's exactly what it was, a request. There was discussion, mixed feelings. I don't know what. One, the $5,000 wasn't being paid back to the city that we had given in years past, that we found out. And they were, plus they were paying another $5,000 to $8,000 in overtime.
So, and I had a conversation this past week with several of the council members, mm-hmm. and they said that they're not actually spending the $5,000 that they're allocating now in their line item budget. So I was very
did what now,
honey?
What council person told? I'm sorry, I don't understand.
Several of the council members have shared with me that they're not spending the allotment of $5,000 in overtime because we're not.
Well,
looking,
I'm sorry, but they are.
We're not looking to fund overtime for police and fire and rescue. We were thinking that $5,000 was used for the purpose of a city cleanup.
It is.
And you know, I have. And I know people's budgets change from day to day and year to year and month to month. So I'm looking at the tourism profit loss budget overview for this coming year, and I see that we have a projected line item in there of $10,000 and $5,000 for the city cleanup. So I'm just curious at how we are deviating from that. And I know our request. I truly understand it. But, you know, I came out here myself and extended a serious olive branch trying to build a relationship. And all I've heard in the city of Paintsville for the past 2 weeks is conversation out of this commission talking about what a poor job that the Kentucky Apple Festival does. All I've heard is that you all are bringing us down, wanting to talk about we ought to do commercialized vending. Kiwanis members coming to me saying, let me tell you what's being said, and they're telling your all's names. You know, commercialized vending is not going to do anything but take the money from the city of Paintsville out of our county on October the 4th. Now, I'm just saying that I know that there's been difficult times throughout the years. That wasn't with me, and when I was out here 5 weeks ago, I thought we were coming to some sort of agreement. One of your members came to my board, and she listened to us, and she had positive comments for us, and we had positive feedback, I thought, when she left. I thought we had built some sort of mutual alliance to say, here's where we are. Here's what the things that we're talking about. All I'm curious about, I'm not laying the blame game to anybody. I'm just saying that I offered a proposition, I extended an olive branch, and I said, here's what I'm thinking we should be doing as a group to come together for the betterment of the city of Paintsville. I appreciate your time, Jim, and I understand that you all took a different path on funding for the Kentucky Apple Festival. And I appreciate that. I appreciate what you all have done. But I don't have to agree. But I appreciate it, Jim.
Okay, thank you. Any discussion from members? Questions of Jimmy?
I'll tell you what I think. Us going and doing the advertisement was one of the most important things we could do because you don't advertise it. They haven't been doing it for years. People around this state have forgotten what the Paintsville, Johnson County Apple Festival was. And that's not my fault. It's not your fault. You just got here, right? I tell you about everybody else sitting on there. It's fault.
This is only my second year. And you know, in the budget, I'm looking at advertisement for this board of $71,000. $5,000 from the Kentucky Apple Festival isn't going to help that.
Okay.
Now, I love what you all done. I love the advertisement that she's going
to
propose and the things that we're going to do. But $15,000.
We're just not going to turn a check over to you and let you decide anymore.
And
that's what I think.
we come to that decision. And that's just not gonna happen. We're gonna try to help it the best way we think it should go. Because that money's coming from us, not you.
No. It's coming from us.
All of us, yes.
Yes, I am.
And we're in the you're in control of the money from the Apple stuff, and we're in control of the tourism.
Absolutely.
Okay?
Then absolutely.
We decided that's the way the money needs to go.
And I can completely understand that. I can completely understand. I don't
right.
have that
I
issue.
My issue is turning carte blanche to just giving y'all a check.
Yeah.
No.
Well, it's one of the things. Part of the discussion was, one, that even the $5,000 wasn't given back to the city for trash pickup.
For 2 years.
Let me go back and address that. Tourism started. I can't fix what something happened.
I know. I'm getting beat.
Well, it sounds like you're angry. Are you angry?
I am not understanding how you all are beating me with something that happened years ago.
It's got to show a change, and if they're not willing to change, you can't just keep trying the same thing over and over if it doesn't work.
I agree.
Okay.
You're
when we were at the state fair, we mentioned Kentucky Apple Festival. People thought it was in Casey County. Casey County runs a big apple festival. They knew nothing about it.
And it wasn't just random. They honestly thought
hundreds,
it was Casey County.
Hundreds of people.
When Laura went to your all's meeting,
yes,
and asked about advertising and said, we don't need any. Now, look at WIMT this week. Black Gold Festival, Chicken Festival. That's all you've seen for the last 2 months have been festivals advertising. People have to see those. They don't know about it. The state used to say 125,000 people in Paintsville for the Apple Festival. Now they're saying 50 to 60,000. It's dropped off that much. The general public says that. We're not.
I remember hearing that. 6 weeks ago, Jim, you said that those were one of the things that you talked about was advertising.
Mm-hmm.
But you had free venues for us. You said that there was free opportunities for advertisers.
There was.
And I was excited to hear that.
Mm-hmm.
And
we've
used
got some
them.
Of them.
Right. And we've used them.
So, and, you know, it took us a different path. So it's not pro or con. You know, I'm just here to express, and the only reason I'm here is I was here the last time.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
I left the room thinking that we had made up ground.
We did. I talked to you out front after that and told you.
Yes,
we said nothing but complimentary things.
Mm-hmm.
And that's the truth. And I don't know who's coming to you.
In the community,
you know, this he said, she said stuff. Then they need to come to us.
Yeah.
Because we certainly have not.
It just.
Do we think things should change? Sure.
Negative.
Well, we've heard some pretty negative things too.
Mm-hmm.
So.
Yeah, but I can say that I didn't say one of them.
And I believe
that. I didn't say a single thing. Because I'm going to tell you, we went into executive session, and I defended what I did out here that night, whether everybody liked it or not. I defended me extending that olive branch to say, no, this board must work with that board because we do better, the city of Paintsville, together instead of separate.
Mm-hmm.
But I can't go back and fix what happened. I can't do it.
You can look at the future.
And that's what I keep trying to do. I keep trying to say that. And I was hoping, right or wrong, and I said it to you all, if it didn't get better, then I didn't want to be part of that.
Mm-hmm.
But I was hoping that the commission would take that step to say, you know, he came out here, let's fund his proposal this year, and let's see where
it
goes.
I think you're looking just backwards at it. Show us a reason to. You know, you've got other festivals contributing back to the community.
We tribute. We have 35 nonprofit organizations. We don't.
They
know money.
They're doing that themselves.
Yep, yeah, they spend their dollars in our town. We could
That's
easily
exactly
do
right.
exactly like, what was it, 3 years ago or 4 years ago? There was a kettle corn booth set up over by the Browns dealership.
Mm-hmm.
Kiwanis come and said,
mm-hmm.
you know, there's a for profit kettle corn booth set up. We had to push forward and shut it down.
Mm-hmm.
Because that was against
and
our
I, And I, quite frankly, am a Kiwanian, and I don't know of a Kiwanian that would talk about us.
Mm-hmm.
I am a Kiwanian, and I don't preach that either.
I know.
Mm-hmm.
I don't.
I know.
We're an awful tight bunch.
Thank you, Jim.
Thank you. Any further discussion or questions?
I had a question to you guys out in the hallway after that, after it was over, and it still aggravates me. One of the biggest draws to Apple Day itself was the Apple Bowls, and I'm not talking about Paintsville Johnson Central. They were great, brought a lot of people in there. But you had a very good opportunity to attract people to number one in the state football teams playing the same weekend Apple Day. Did you know that? Is that something y'all would think about advertising for Apple Day again? They're both playing Thursday and Friday night right here. That's something we needed. When you spot that, we got to jump on something like that to help Apple Day.
I agree. And you know, we need to partner with Johnson Central, bring up a facility to house that event.
Well, there's two stadiums. They're playing two nights. They don't have to be at the same stadium.
Yeah, we had 5,000
almost
last time Hansel played over there.
Yeah.
The crowd was off the
track. Great. I was right
big
there.
Event. I was there myself.
The Pikel.
We had a great time.
But, you know, that's something I ask about that should have been, you know, working with the schools. Let's have home games Friday and Saturday night every Apple Day. That's something I'm...
I absolutely agree.
Yeah. That's my suggestion. I'm done.
Anything else? Any other questions, comments? If not, Stephanie.
Well, I guess that the first thing I'll say is that I hope that we do right by the $5,000 budget this year in promoting Apple Days. And I felt that, as you see, it's marketed highly out in the state. We want people to come here. So I reached out and did a proposal. I brought it to the board. They okayed the proposal of spending that money to do 15-second ads the week leading up, which is the most bang for our buck, talking about the festival. And it's going to be online as well, and it's WKYT, WIMT, and WSAZ. So you're going to reach quite a big number of people going that route. We've also advertised within the Apple Book, the official Apple magazine, and with Big Sandy, we're going to do an ad there as well. And then on the 29th, I will be going to do the show Everyday Moms, and I will be talking about Apple Days and the run and what's going on and inviting people to come here. And I think that I hope that that brings more people into the area, because you do have to advertise. And we do, you know, it's one thing to advertise locally, but it's as important to advertise to tell people to come to our area and participate and see what we're all about. And so, you know, let's just hope that from this works and we see more foot traffic here and interest in what we're doing in this area, and it's the right way to go for next year.
Any questions, Stephanie?
Do you want me to discuss any of the other advertising? Or
yeah, you can.
Okay, and so... I'm just now wrapping up. We had a ton of ads that were due, the official state magazine and the travel magazine, and so I'm just finishing on those, and we sent the one today for the Kentucky state magazine, and I'm happy to send that around to show you what we looked at. We're working on right now, we're doing a paddling in October, and we've put a flyer together, and it's going to be Paintsville and Prestonsburg again doing it. And we have decided, after meeting with the mayors, that we are going to start in spring, and we're going to pick a month, a Saturday in the month, and we're going to have a paddle festival once a month and invite people. We've actually, from what has already transpired, had much interest from different kayaking organizations. What we didn't know about this. How can we know about it? So we're going to reach out and try to bring as many people here to paddle. And then we've got the carriage ride, which they are actually closing down the Dawkins with a special permit to do this carriage ride. So it's something we need to work on promoting as well, and promoting the Dawkins, because it's a great trail. It's a perfect time to do it for fall. So we've done some of our Blue Ridge Outdoor magazine. We actually decided just to go that route with promoting the Dawkins. And we have an article going in for October online part of it. And then I guess Lynette and I discussed the other day, we'll have at the home place the holiday Christmas, and I'm looking forward to working on that once we have it solidified of what we need to promote. But I actually think it's a great idea, as is the pumpkin house. And we just, there's a folder here, and it is Kentucky's Appalachia, and I went and met in Frankfort on Thursday with some of the representatives talking about the importance of our communities, or five counties, working together to try to find one, try to do one website where we can put all of our information in, and we can promote everything going on in our area. Because if something's going on in Pikeville, and we've got people up there, well, why can we not invite them down here? Say, oh, well, they've got this going on. What event could we put together the next night and encourage those people to come? And just recognize that, you know, we've got to stay strong together and promote each other and work together, and recognize if they're having fun in one part of our Eastern Kentucky area, then they're going to be interested in what else is going on. And Paintsville has a lot of great things going on. And so I went down looking for funding to try to make Kentucky's Appalachia come into fruition. We have, if you'll notice in the packets, all the mayors, judge executives, tourism, have signed letters of support, and that's what I'm pushing. So hopefully it happens. Do you all have any questions for me?
Just a comment. You're doing a wonderful job.
Yeah, I agree.
Thank you so very much. Yeah. We appreciate it.
Well, hopefully.
Certainly do.
Hopefully it works.
If you want to do that carriage ride, how do you sign up for that?
Well, yeah, that was a question posed to us, and I did not have the full understanding. And I guess that, and Russell, you might know a little bit more about that carriage ride just because he's your buddy. But, I mean, apparently there were only so many slots allowed, and those slots were very quickly filled.
Mm-hmm.
And so we've had questions to come in here. Lynette has asking, well, tell me about the carriage
mm-hmm.
ride. And I contacted the Friends of Our Dolphins, who are kind of putting it together, and you're welcome to go out and get on the trail to observe it, but the slots are already taken.
Okay.
So now it's just, I guess, spreading the word, and you know, if it goes well, maybe next year they can have it.
Well, if it's full, it sounds like it's gone well.
Yes,
you know?
Yes.
I mean, those slots
how
are in less than a week.
Yeah.
Time.
Yes,
yeah.
They were
day.
Gone in
that
yeah.
three,
this day.
Do
is that 3 weeks
do
off?
Do you have two? How many people are going to ride in your carriage? Two?
I'd like two.
Two of us.
Two.
Look at
the
blondes.
Oh, okay. Great.
Richard, if you want to go along, you can help the horse pull.
Yeah.
Actually, he can drive if he wants to.
Yeah.
That's a long trip.
It is a long trip.
But I think it's obvious just within days the spots were filled, so it's obvious that it's going to be a successful venture. They might want to consider more carriages, more horses, more
mm-hmm.
opportunities
for
people
first
to experience
year they
that.
To make sure it was
mm-hmm.
controlled, no injuries.
Yeah.
And
yeah.
Yeah.
But I can see that growing. I can see that being a real tourist attraction. Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
I can
you wonder
see
how many carriages and horses are out there.
Well,
I mean, you.
And I think that's the nostalgia
day.
Of it is
yeah.
the big draw. Yeah.
Uh-huh.
Yeah. It's one thing to ride a bike that 18 miles. It's another to sit in leisure and ride a carriage. Riding a bike's not everybody's gig. So I can see it growing. I can see it becoming quite the fixture.
Okay. Anything else before we go into executive session?
Oh, would you want to make a motion for the bid on the bike bid, or do you have to do that later?
We have to do it with application when we get the application in. Or we can go ahead and do that, I guess, now.
Well, I didn't know who's authorized to sign the application and the notes. Last time it was Todd and Lynette.
Okay.
So
Jonathan?
Still be the business manager and chair.
Yeah, it'd just be me and Lynette would be on that sense.
In fact, I think you have to have in the minutes who's authorized to sign those, Johnson. Like the city does when they work with that they authorize the mayor to sign.
Well, I mean, it's okay if you want to take a motion, but I think generally entering the contract, any contract, mm-hmm. you know, the chair can sign based upon Yeah, I think that's what was approved when Todd was chair.
No, they made a motion.
Well, I know they made the motion for the chair to be able to sign.
Right.
And
let's make the motion, just put it out.
Okay.
I'll make the motion, just change the sign.
We do motion and second, and everybody votes aye.
Don't get complicated.
Okay.
I have a motion from Richard that the chairman
and
the business manager or the secretary be authorized to sign the note. Is that correct?
Yes.
And Bonnie seconded it. All in favor say aye.
It don't matter.
Okay. It's covered, y'all.
It's covered.
So Lynette can fill out all the paperwork.
Okay. She wouldn't sign unless that motion was in there, but she's smart.
No, I was like Jonathan. I thought it was just a blanket thing that we did for the other one. So I didn't think anything else needed to be done.
Was it specific for what?
Uh-huh.
Oh, so.
It was. This one was a blanket that the chairman and secretary, that was the motion Richard made.
Okay.
Yeah. So that doesn't happen again. Anything else? Do I have a motion for executive session pursuant to KRS 61.8101C and F to discuss individual job descriptions for employees?
Make that motion.
Jump up there.
Motion by Andrea.
It's a change
second.
In individual employees.
Yes.
Job. It's
individual employees job description.
Okay.
Yes.
Not generally job descriptions,
no.
But
individual.
Some changes are going to affect certain employees.
Certain
right?
Employees.
Okay.
That's correct.
All
right. Motion made and seconded. All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Opposed.
not a logo, you can manipulate to make into a note card. But more importantly, it's a logo that is very one-sided. It's where the mountains meet the music. And we are music, but in all honesty, we are much more than music. And I would like to be able to work on us getting a new logo that is more encompassing of what Paintsville's tourism is. We were looking at ads and how a lot of the different commission tourism offices, it's not just one thing, and we are. And when we have some music events, you could easily put that on there because it's a beautiful logo. But, you know, when we're doing the paddle festival or, you know, other stuff, it's kind of a difficult logo to utilize.
Paddle festival, yeah, dueling banjos.
Yeah, no, paddle. So I'm asking for the permission to reach out and try to have a new logo.
Yeah, have some and bring them to us.
Motion to adjourn. Second. You all have ready.
Adjourn.